World Bank states that Ripple XRP will play a big role in our future financial system. Over the past few years, we've seen Ripple expanding. In particular, Ripple's relation with the most powerful global financial institutions are strengthening. The Bank of International Settlements has signaled that Ripple XRP will be the new financial system, whereas World Bank also stated that it will play a big role in our future financial system. But what makes XRP reach such heights? Let's find out. Hey guys, and welcome back to Crypto Millionaires, a channel where we give you information about investing in crypto. Please like and subscribe if you are new here to get everything you need to know about cryptocurrencies. In today's video, you will know about the connection between Ripple and the top world financial institutions, what World Bank has to say about Ripple XRP and its products, and what makes XRP to be the favorite of such financial institutions. So let's start our video. Ripple connection with World Bank and IMF. Through different meetings and speeches, we have come to know that there is a connection between Ripple, World Bank, and IMF. Christine Lagarde, ex-managing director of IMF, has revealed information regarding how the IMF envisions and what the future financial system will look like. The IMF envisions that they will hold a more central role in the future, as well as a more central role of the world's central banks. It is no secret that IMF and Ripple have been seen together on several occasions, such as conferences and festivals, as well as at Swell. Most notably in Singapore, when Brad Garlinghouse and former Deputy General Counsel from the IMF by the name of Ross Lacow were alone together on the stage. Through the discussion in Singapore, it is likely that something is being planned that we are not aware of relating to cryptocurrencies and the IMF. According to the analyst, the IMF is the one that has been organizing meetings between Ripple and central banks. The analysts believe that the IMF organized this meeting for Ripple with the intent of trying to push Ripple's technology to the central banks. Also, at the Swiss National Bank Conference, there were some very high-level financial representatives gathered. Many representatives were from central banks, as well as the head of the Bank of International Settlements. The managing director of IMF at the time, Christine Lagarde, was also there, along with Brad Garlinghouse, who was the only representative from the private sector sitting at the front table. The IMF has realized the potential for the technology that Ripple holds and that they are actively trying to make central banks and other financial institutions adopt the technology. IMF realizes that the role they see for the IMF could become a reality by utilizing the technology Ripple has to offer. IMF sees the central banks as much more central in the future to the financial system. They are trying to create this relationship with the IMF in the center of all the central banks, where all payments are being routed through the central banks. The analysts are of the view that a new financial system is being implemented where the IMF, central banks, and Ripple's technology, with XRP at the center. XRP products are real-world solutions. World Bank. In a report written by Marco Nicoli, who is a senior financial sector specialist in the innovations global practice of the World Bank, the World Bank heaped praises on distributed ledgers, in particular Ripple, and called Ripple's XRapid as potentially transformational technology. Ripple's XRapid was being praised in that report, and it was called as a real-world solution that is being actively tested, according to the report. These shortcomings make the cross-border payment industry ripe for disruption and innovation. Some of these distributed ledger technologies, or DLTs, has the potential to drive industry-wide change. DLT solutions could potentially bypass the de-risking issue altogether by enabling remittance service providers to operate without the need for a correspondent banking relationship. On XRapid, the report says that in 2018, Ripple, a fintech company, piloted XRapid, a DLT-based cross-border payment solution, along the very competitive US-Mexico corridor. The transfer of funds on XRapid took 2 to 3 seconds, with most of the processing time explained by domestic payment rails and intermediary digital asset exchanges. On the potential of distributed ledgers dominating cross-border payments in the long term, whether DLT will be an effective solution to the challenges the remittances industry faces, and when the technology will reach sufficient scale to effectively disrupt this space remain to be answered. In any case, there is a simple opportunity, and of course, need, for innovation in the cross-border payment industry. Blockchain technology and digital assets like XRP can create a more frictionless cross-border payment experience. Ripple's mission is to remove friction from global payments and enable money to move the same way that information does today, digitally and instantaneously. In a blog on Ripple Insight, it is written that banks and financial institutions can bring cross-border payment methods into the modern world and provide a truly frictionless experience that reduces the many pain points customers are facing today, will emerge as leaders in tomorrow's global payment industry. Interledger is very promising. World Bank. The World Bank Group calls the Interledger protocol very promising for interoperability in the payment domain. World Bank has prepared a new blockchain report together with the International Monetary Fund's Digital Advisory Team, for that a study conducted on the connection paths between different blockchains. In that study, money transfer was made between Ethereum and XRP Ledger networks via Interledger, and how Polkadot can be combined with different blockchains was measured. Interledger, developed by Ripple's former CTO Stefan Thomas. It is an open-source protocol that enables money transfers between different blockchain networks, and as a result of this research, it was declared that the Interledger platform is a promising technology for the payment industry. Thanks to this Ripple Interledger protocol, a money transfer sent in XRP form can be delivered to the receiving party in ETH, USD, or EUR. The researchers who used Ethereum and XRP Ledger during the test had a positive result. In the report where different blockchains were examined, it is said that it is very difficult to compare Polkadot with Ethereum yet. Known as the Ethereum killer, Polkadot can combine different blockchain networks at a common point. World Bank and IMF researchers have tested substrate technology developed to make it easier to connect to the Polkadot network. It was stated that the substrate provides more flexible opportunities to the blockchain developers than usual, and the development process can accelerate in this way. However, it has been stated that Polkadot cannot be compared to Ethereum, which has yet achieved good momentum. The reason why XRP will play a role in our future financial systems. Ripple XRP is a currency with a purpose. As far as cryptocurrencies go, Ripple is a microcap option compared to Bitcoin and Ethereum. This means investors in XRP appear to like the growth trajectory of this smaller cryptocurrency relative to its larger peers. When XRP was initially designed, investors had a goal in mind. Ripple's founders wanted to create a cryptocurrency designed specifically for real-world use cases. This is an extremely important fact, and the one investors need to take seriously. XRP solves a key problem in cross-border payments involving two different currencies. The XRP decentralized blockchain technology allows for transactions to be settled almost instantaneously. We all know how the SWIFT process works. This technology is a huge upgrade. Having a transaction approved in as little as 3 to 5 seconds as opposed to 1 to 5 business days is a real-world upgrade. XRP is the cryptocurrency that provides the bank with on-demand liquidity. A liquidity pool of XRP, which is used to source the international pool for the users of RippleNet. While RippleNet aims to solve the problem of confirmation and DB management, the XRP on-chain liquidity aims to provide instantaneous conversion and payment into any fiat currency on demand. According to Ripple, it will help reduce the cost for banks by 40 to 60%. RippleNet has also a play in making XRP on top of the list of financial institutions. It is a decentralized network using XRP's ledger and the XRP cryptocurrency to provide a global payment platform for users. This platform is widely used globally and is growing in influence, though perhaps maybe not to the degree many have expected in recent years. The advantage of using RippleNet is mainly related to the transaction headaches caused by international transfers. RippleNet provides businesses with a cheaper and more efficient option. Transactions are settled immediately and in the local currency on both sides. This is obviously advantageous to large multinational companies and those with cross-border banking needs. Banks and financial institutions appreciate Ripple more than any other cryptocurrency. As a result, it makes sure worldwide industries adopt it to greater extent. The digital asset in a WEIS rating survey turned out to be more popular in the US than Bitcoin. A standout is a recognition of the World Bank and the mentioning of cost savings and speed of XRP. As a solution that seeks to change the status quo, benefiting the end user, the global financer notes that Ripple's solution has the possibility of impacting people's lives positively. Being one of Ripple's core product, XRapid does leverage XRP as a medium of exchange. So guys, this is it for today's video. I hope it could be a big help for you. What do you think of XRP's role in the future financial system? Let us know in the comments section. Don't forget to click the bell icon. And thanks for watching.